Hey guys, Kevin at GloveRelace.com, and today I'm going to answer a question that I've been asked quite frequently here on YouTube, on my Facebook page, through my website. And that question is, Kevin, how do you break in a baseball glove? The process I'm about to go over is my personal opinion on how I've been breaking in gloves here at GloveRelace.com in my entire life now. I'm not that old, I'm only 25, but I've worked at several sports shops in which we offered a break-in service. This is what they adopted, and this is what I've always followed by. Please keep in mind that GloveRelace.com, we do not offer a break-in service due to the fact that each and every glove is his own player's glove. It is broken into that player's specifications. I can give you my idea on how I break it in, and I'll let you decide if that's the route you want to take. So let's go ahead and I'll show you how to break in a glove. There's three things you need in order to break in a glove. Obviously a glove, a plastic baggie, preferably a larger one, and I have here a piece of black glove lace. Being a glove relacer, I have the ability to have these products, but a shoelace, anything you can use to tie a glove shut will work perfectly. So let's begin. Most gloves, in my opinion, every glove I've seen, whether it's a Rawlings, an Easton, a Wilson, a $400 glove, a $50 glove, they're all going to have what you see here as this V-notch. Let me get a little close-up there. You can see the V-notch of the lace. This is also known as the palm lacing. If you were to imagine a dotted line right here through that V-notch, a straight dotted line, imagine that as the break-in line. That's where you want your glove broken in. Let me show you what I mean. Imagine that dotted line right there between the V piece of lace, and breaking that glove right on that dotted line to give it a good close. Let me show you what it looks like on my hand. V-notch, close it right on that dotted line there. What you'll do is, now I broke this one in intentionally this way because I want to show you what other people have been doing. A lot of people will break it in on the thumb, as you can see the crease there, and close it in like that. What that does, it leaves a hole in the middle for that ball to pop right out. So if you go from that to that, what you can see here right on that V-notch line, you give yourself a nice closed pocket. So let me show you my way of doing that. Okay, so first you want to do, you want to oil the glove. And I'm not going to show you how to oil it in this video. I'll have another video where you can see how I oil gloves with the conditioner oil that I use. But once the glove is completely oiled, both inside and out, you want to look at that V-notch, and what you want to do is you want to fold the pinky right through that V-notch. I'm going to try and see if I can do it upside down here. So take the glove, fold that pinky in right on the V-notch, and then roll it into itself. You should get a glove that looks kind of like that. At this point, let me rephrase that. You can put a ball in it if you want. I opt not to, but that's obviously your own opinion. A ball will make the pocket a little bit deeper. So once you have it rolled up just like that, I'll take my piece of lace. You can use shoelace too. Bear with me 1 second. I'm going to pop this out of screen. Take the shoelace, tie it down. Not super tight, but enough to where it keeps it shut. You don't want to create any kind of grooves or get any kind of black dye on your glove. So I went ahead and tied it. 2 knots on both sides. 1 knot's fine as long as it stays shut. And remember, your glove is now oiled. It's rolled into itself and now tied up with a piece of lace, shoelace, anything you can use to tie the glove. Take your plastic baggie, put your glove in that bag, and let's close the bag. Now, I was born and raised in Los Angeles, California. I now reside in Round Rock, Texas, which is just out of Austin, Texas, so it's hot most of the year here, so this works for me. But you primarily want to do what I'm about to tell you in the summer months. Most of you know when you get into a car in the summer months, it's hot. You know, the dashboard is really hot, the steering wheel is hot. I like to use that as the spot for breaking in my gloves. So let's say, for example, I know it's November right now, but let's say it's the middle of August, it's hot outside. Once it's ziplocked in the bag, I will put it on the dashboard of my car. What this is going to allow it to do, it's going to allow the sun to basically steam, heat, or cook your glove keeping the oil and the steam from the oil within the bag. And it's basically just gonna keep cooking the inside and out of the glove. Now, after about an hour, I leave it in there for about an hour, you can take your glove out. Obviously, I'm not gonna, it's November, I'm not gonna be doing this right now. Take the glove out, unwrap the lace, and I can tell you right now, glove's gonna be hot, especially on the inside palm. The glove's gonna be very hot. When you take your brand new glove out, whether it's, like I said, if it's a $400 glove, a $300 glove, the ones that come extremely stiff, catcher's mitts, first baseman's mitts, it's gonna feel very broken in. I mean, it's gonna feel like, oh my God, I only need to do this once. In about 20 to 30 minutes, it's gonna stiffen right back up again. So, in that 20 to 30 minutes, while it's feeling pretty good, that's when you wanna start playing catch. If you have a mitt mallet or your hand, just start breaking it in that way, but it will stiffen up again, don't worry. If you do that process over a 2 week period, maybe once a day with lightly oiling it, throw it in the car, let it steam cook, take it out, play catch, I feel your glove will be game ready in a few weeks instead of waiting a few months. Now, if you go to my website, GloveRelace.com, in the facts and questions section, I do offer this full service. I broke it down for you. I go over exactly what I just said. And if you don't feel comfortable breaking in your glove using my way or someone else's way, you can always just play catch. That's the simplest way to break in your glove, is just play catch and do it right. Don't try and speed up the service by doing something like, for example, putting the glove in the oven. I know many people have had success with it, but I can tell you, I've seen many horror stories here at GloveRelace.com where I get a brand new glove shipped to me, laces are fried, leather's thin. Unfortunately, I gotta tell them, hey, the glove's not salvageable. So keep that in mind. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them on this video or shoot me an email through GloveRelace.com. And that's about it. Thanks a lot, guys.